this week, which is question three. Question three, what do the scriptures principally teach? Well, this is the last question in the introductory questions, or the foundational questions that we have in the catechism. And then next week we will go on to look at the nature of God and the works of God in questions 4 to 12. But question 3 reads, what do the scriptures principally teach? The scriptures principally teach what man is to believe concerning God and what duty God requires of man. This is reminiscent of the words of Calvin when he talks about the knowledge of God and the knowledge of ourselves. What we are to believe regarding the nature of God, and then as a consequence of that, what duty or what obedience God requires of us. The scriptures teach many things. The scriptures go into many subjects. But the principal things that the Bible teaches is what we are to believe about the character and nature and attributes of God. If we miss that, we miss the central theme of the Word of God. And then if we never get to the point of what God expects us to do, again, we are failing to read the scriptures with profit. We are failing to read the scriptures to their proper end. Some people have read the Bible. One of the famous Irish authors, George Bernard Shaw, spoke glowingly of the Authorized Version, but never lived it, never followed its precepts. And that is, if nothing else, foolishness. So we must, as we come to the Bible, as we come to the Word of God, we must have in focus what we are meant to, the points of which we are meant to principally come, and that is the nature of God and the obedience that God requires of us. 2 Timothy 1 verse 13, hold fast the form of sound words which thou hast heard of me in faith and love which is in Christ Jesus. We are to be the type of people that not only read the scriptures and not only believe them, but we are those who are, as it says in the verse here, to hold them fast, securely, that we would never let them go. Ecclesiastes 12 and verse 13, let us hear the conclusion of the whole matter. Fear God and keep His commandments, for this is the whole duty of man. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom, which will lead to an obedient life. It's only when we understand God and understand our relationship to Him that we will live properly in a context of a relationship with Him. This is reminiscent, if you like, of question one. This is the whole duty of man. What is man's chief end? Man's chief end, his principal end, is to glorify God and to enjoy Him forever. So question three, what do the scriptures principally teach? The scriptures principally teach what man is to believe concerning God and what duty God requires of man. So let us turn in our Psalters to Psalm 100.